The purpose of the centrifugal pump lab is to obtain performance characteristics of a centrifugal pump and compare the results to data provided by the pump manufacturer. There are two centrifugal pumps, A and B, connected to a pipe network. This video will demonstrate how to run the experiment when only pump A is operational. You should consult your instructor if you plan to run this experiment using pump B as well. Water flows from a large storage tank through a series of ball valves to the centrifugal pump. The water then passes through a globe valve, a turbine flow meter, and more ball valves before returning to the storage tank. The flow rate through the pipe network is controlled by the globe valve and measured using the turbine flow meter. The pump is connected to a motor by a shaft. The shaft has a torque meter and tachometer attached to it. The pump performance characteristics will be calculated using data from the display panel. The data of interest are the shaft torque, angular velocity of the shaft, differential pressure across the pump, and volumetric flow rate. To set up this experiment, first turn on the instrument panel. Then open appropriate ball valves. And finally, open the flow control valve slightly. Turn on the instrument panel by flipping the toggle switch on its right-hand side and record any offsets on the displays. Take care to note the units for each measurement on the display panel. Torque is expressed in pound-inches. Angular velocity is expressed in rotations per minute. Differential pressure across the pump is expressed in pounds per square inch, and volumetric flow rate is expressed in gallons per minute. Make sure the appropriate ball valves are open near the pump and in the middle of the pipe network. All other ball valves should be closed. Open the flow control valve slightly by giving it about a 1/4 turn in the counterclockwise direction. In order to conduct this experiment, first your instructor will turn on the pump and set it to 1150 RPM. Then you will record data at different flow rates. Your instructor will then adjust the pump to 1750 RPM. Then you will repeat the experiment at that speed. Your instructor will turn on the pump using the following procedure. Open the clear plastic shield to expose the controls on the frequency driver. Turn the red knob clockwise to turn on the frequency driver and wait for the display to read RDY. Press the down button once and then press the ENT button. Use the up and down arrows to adjust the pump rotational speed. Set this value to 19.2, which corresponds to 1150 rotations per minute. Then press the run button to start the pump. Verify that the pump rotational speed on the display panel reads 1150 RPM. Fully open the flow control valve by turning it counterclockwise. This is the maximum flow rate. Record the torque, pump rotational speed, differential pressure across the pump, and flow rate from the display panel. Since some values fluctuate, take an average over the course of a few seconds. Calculate 85% of the maximum flow rate and adjust the flow control valve until the flow rate on the display panel is approximately that value. Record data at this new flow rate. Reduce the flow rate to 70%, 55%, 40%, and 25% of the maximum flow rate and record data from the display panel at each step. To obtain data when there is no flow through the pipe network, the instructor will fully close the flow control valve while students record data from the display panel. This data should be obtained quickly, as leaving the valve closed longer than a minute can damage the pump. Once the data is recorded at zero flow rate, the instructor will reopen the valve. The instructor will set the pump rotational speed to 1750 RPM using the following procedure. First, press the stop button on the frequency driver control panel. Then use the up and down arrows to adjust the display to 29.3, which corresponds to the desired speed. Then press the run button and verify that the pump rotational speed on the display panel reads 1,750 RPM. Students will repeat the experimental procedure at a pump rotational speed of 1,750 RPM. In order to shut down the experiment, first, your instructor will turn off the pump. Then, close all the valves and turn off the power to the instrument panel. The instructor will shut down the pump using the following procedure. First, push the stop button on the frequency driver control panel. Then turn the red knob counterclockwise to the off position and close the clear plastic cover. Close all ball valves and the flow control valve. Then turn off the display panel.